This is Laura GB, and in this Power BI video, we are going to look at making a grid chart in Power BI using the Charticulator Visual. So here's our chart that we are going to do today. It's got a grid per person, and the grid is, and the squares in the grid are coloured by what drink choice they have chosen. So our data is 20 rows of data showing people and their drink choices. So let's go back into Power BI and go onto a blank page. And we're going to bring in the Charticulator Visual. I've already added it to this report. And let's just drag that down the page a little bit. So we want it to be based off the people. So I'm going to bring in the person. And then I'm going to bring in what their drink choice was. So I've added drink and person both to the data section. And then we go back to the chart, we click the three dots, and we click edit. And then when the editor comes up, we click create chart to take us into here. So the first step I'm going to do is I'm going to make this a square because I want it to be more of a square shape. So the chart attributes, I'm just going to change the width to say, no, not to say 600, to say 400. So there we go. It's a square. So we are then going to look at the structure that we want it to be, the kind of chart it is. So if I click in the plot area, the plot segment, there up comes a little toolbar and it's offering you the different kinds of layouts that we've got here. So we've got a stack X, we've got a stack Y, grid, packing, etc. So with this one is going to be a grid. And that changes the way the glyph looks. Okay, so if you happen to notice, if you look through those different layouts, you'll see the glyph changes shape over there on the right. So what we're going to do is we're going to add to the glyph. It's very simple this time. It's just going to be a mark. Okay, a mark shape. So I'm going to keep to the rectangle. And I'm going to drag that on to my glyph area. And there we are. We get a rectangle in each of the areas. So the next part we want to do is we want to colour them. So I am then going to minimise the glyph area just so I can see more attributes. And then in the fill, I'm going to click the link button. And I'm going to link it to the drink. And there you are, you will see that we get different coloured squares. Okay, so I'm just going to quickly change these to slightly more appropriate colours. Light blue for coffee isn't quite right. And put in a new value. A little bit more like coffee. And probably that tea is a bit too orange for my liking to be tea. There we go, we've got our colours sorted. Now, talking of sorting, those squares are in the wrong order as to what we'd normally expect them to be. They're all mixed up, which might be what you want, but in my case, I want them sorted so that all the copies are together. So what we do is we click into the grid again, and we'll see the bar comes up, a few extras this time, and we've got a sort button there. So I'm going to go sort, and I want it sorted by drink, not person. And there we are. They've all been put together. Now, how you want them sorted. They've been sorted by number, so that the most are the first, and then come the next. If that's what you want, that's great. But we can change that by clicking on to down on the down right. We can choose which way we want it to go. I'm going to go for upright, so that it starts in the bottom left-hand corner here and works towards the top right in colours. So there we go. We've got that. But those colours don't mean anything to anybody unless we've got a key somewhere else on our page. But we can add a legend. So I'm going to click on the shape fill over here in the scales. And when you click on there, it's where you can edit the colours again, there is an add legend button. So I'm going to add my legend. And there we are, it gets added in on the right there. Now, I don't want it to sit there. I want it to sit above, and I want it little squares, please. So I'm going to click on the legend in the scale section here. And here are the attributes for the legend. So firstly, I'm going to look at the shape. So I don't want it to be a little ellipse or circle as it happens to be. I want it to be, I'm going to pick rectangle, so I get some nice little coloured squares. Also, I don't want a list going downwards. I want it an across. So if you look on the categorical legend, there's an orientation. So I'm going to make that go across like that. Then the next thing I want, so it has an anchor, and that's that little green dot, which at the moment is in the top left-hand corner of our legend. So I want it, firstly, I want my legend to be above it. So if you look at these three here, they choose where it is. So I'm going to click that the green dot should be at the bottom of my, the anchor should be at the bottom of my legend. I also don't want that anchor to be on the left-hand side of my legend. I want it to be on the right-hand side. So if we look here, there is an alignment right. So there we are, the green dot is now at the right end. So that's put my legend where I want it, but we've now got this big gap on the right-hand side. So we can fix that. We can either drag that line up there across, or if you prefer to type in so you know that it's going to be exactly equal, we can go back up into the chart section, okay, where we changed the dimensions earlier, and you'll see there's margins, and we can see we've got a margin of 100 there. So I'm going to change that margin to be 20. I'm also, at the top there, that legend is pretty squeezed in. So let's make that top legend be 30. And there we are, it gives us a bit more space to fit the legend in. So the observant amongst you will have noticed the legend's not sorted. So I'm going to click on to the legend again, and you'll see there is an ordering button, and I can click into there and I can turn around and say, well, we're going to sort it. So there we are, we've got coffee, tea, water. That's alphabetical. Or we could have it the other way round. Well, I'm going to stick to convention and let's go alphabetical, coffee, tea, water, and then click OK. And there we are, it gets sorted. That is my visual. We've got squares per person. We've got a little legend there to show what they are. So let's go back to, click back to report. It asks you about saving the changes. Let's click save. And there we are. We've got our visual. It will expand up to show some bigger squares. And there we are. That is the chart that we aimed to get. So this was creating a grid chart with a Charticulator. If you want to see more videos from me and get notified of when there's a new video, please press subscribe and see you again soon. Take care now.